Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to another video on Jetpack Compose. So in this video, we will actually get to code with the things that we have covered in the previous video. So this is my main activity, and here I am previewing these three screens. This is screen one. You have a button, and on click of that particular button, you navigate to the next screen. Screen two, there are two buttons. Clicking on the top button, you will navigate to the previous screen. And if you click on screen three, you will navigate to the next screen. And on the last screen, there are two more buttons. If you click for home, you will move to the very first screen. Otherwise, you can just move back to the previous screen. So this is a very simple, navigation that I want to implement. Now, how do we go about implementing it? So these are our three screens. These are basically composables. So I have created the whole screen itself with a composable. So all these screens are built with composable. And then here right now in the main activity, I am only rendering screen one. If I run this, what you will basically see is just this screen that is getting rendered. And when I click on this, nothing happens because we have not yet implemented the navigation. So let's get started with implementing the navigation. To do that, let me create a new Kotlin file called as app. And let me just write down the things that I want to implement here. One is nav host, then nav controller, then nav graph, and then destination. Destination is nothing but these individual screens that I have created. This is screen one, screen two, and screen three that you are seeing here. These are the destinations. Now, what I will have to do is I will have to create a nav graph. Nav graph is basically the object that holds all the screens together. So the first thing that I will do is create a nav graph. To create a nav graph, I will basically extend the navigation graph function that is available as a part of the nav graph builder. Now, how do we do it in the Kotlin? You write nav graph builder, and then you basically extend by writing the function that you want to have, that is navigation graph. And most likely you will have to pass the nav controller, because without the nav controller, you will not be able to control the navigation. So that you will have to pass. And once you have that, you can create composable. And if you just have a look at the implementation, the first parameter it takes is a root, which is of type string. So you basically need to decide how you are going to refer to each composable programmatically, using which you can control the navigation. So what I will do is I will use screen one as the string, and then under that I will have screen one, and in the same way screen two, and here screen three. So we have basically now set up all the three screens. Now, if you go to the screen one here, on click of this particular button, you want to navigate. And to navigate, you need a nav controller. Now, in that case, what we will have to do is we will have to pass nav controller to the screen one. So what I will do is I will add one more parameter for all these screens. Nav controller, here also nav controller, and here also nav controller. So all of these screens now have the nav controller. Now coming back to the app.kt, let me pass this nav controller to each of these screens. Now what we have done is we have created navigation graph, but now we also need to create nav host. Now to do that, what we will do is we will create a composable function app. And what we will do is we will create a variable of type nav controller, and we will initialize it by remember nav controller. This returns me a nav controller, but with a composable state management built into and baked into it. So that is the reason why I am using remember nav controller, that gives me the nav controller. just recall what nav controller is. It is basically used to control the navigation. Now, what I will do is, I will create the nav host inside the app. How do I do that? Once again, nav host. There are two mechanisms to do this. So I will use this one, nav controller, and then start destination is this one, that is screen one. That is the first screen that I want to be rendered. And then the builder is this. So what we can do is navigation graph, pass the nav controller. That's it. So we have now basically bound together all the things. Destinations are the screens. We have created the navigation graph. We passed that navigation graph here to the nav host. Nav host takes the parameter of the nav controller. And then start destination, you are basically telling what is your first screen. In this case, it is screen one. And this app, I can basically now load in my main activity. So instead of screen one, I can write app. And I can create a dummy nav controller here under the composable preview so that I can pass the nav controller here so that it can render properly in the preview. Now preview is taken care. Now if I just run this, well, the reason why you might be getting this particular error is we have not added the much required dependency. So let me just go back and check whether in the build I have added the dependency. Yeah, that is the problem. So let me add the much needed dependency here. I will have to add implementation navigation compose. Let me add the nav version as well so that this resolves. Let me sync now. Yeah, it is working fine. And now let me just go back and try to run this. Yeah, the first screen loaded. But when I click on this, nothing is happening because I have not yet added what should happen on click. So let me go to the screen one here. And on click, what I can do is nav controller dot navigate. And here you can give the screen name for the next screen, which is screen two. That is navigate. And there are various ways to do this. In this case, I will just use the root mechanism and pass screen two. And now if I run this and click on this, you should be able to navigate to the screen two. So let me go to the screen two here. On click of second button, I should go to the screen three. That is navigate controller dot navigate screen three. And if you click on this button, you should go back. For that, we have navigation controller dot pop backstack. So you go to the previous screen. So you are basically treating it as a stack of screens, pretty similar to activity task or a fragment stack. And then if you go here, once again on click of this, you want to navigate back to previous screen. And here you want to go to home. Now to go to home, how this is done is nav controller dot pop backstack, and then you can actually tell where you want to go here. So one way to do it is nav controller dot graph dot start destination ID. That is, you want to go to the very first screen, and you can say inclusive. Do you want to pop that screen as well? No, I want to be there on that particular first screen from where I had started. So that is why you basically tell inclusive false. And in this way, you basically go back to the first screen, but don't really pop it. So now let me stop this and rerun this again. Click on this, you got to the second screen. Click on this, you got to the third screen. Click on previous, you went back to the previous screen. And if I click for home, you went back to the very first screen. So we have basically now set up a simple navigation, but I am pretty sure you have a lot of questions like what exactly is happening in the nav controller. Do I know the screens that are getting popped and pulled into the screen? How do I control that? Is there a way to control that? So this and more and lot of other questions I will try to address in the next video. So stay tuned.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.